Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at all the different printing options you have in iPhoto. So I'm using iPhoto version 9.5. I'm going to show you printing photos. Now, of course, you can select photos. Let's go into an event here and select a set of photos. And you can order prints, which is handy to do. But if, say, you want to use your own printer, then you want to go to just the regular print function. And then here you have a variety of options on the right. For instance, you could fill each page with the photo. You could fill it with a closer margin right there. This one will fit the fit and fill. The difference is that fit is going to make sure that the entire photo is printed, even if there has to be some larger margins above and below or to left and right. Whereas fill might crop out some parts of the photo, like the left and right sides, so it always fills the entire sheet. You could do a standard 8x10. Or you can also do 5x7s and 4x6s, and it'll group those two per page. You can also choose custom, and custom then will allow you to select aspect ratios. In this case, I'm just going to leave it there on the custom effect, and then I'm going to change the photo size so you can shrink it down or enlarge it. And if it gets too large for one page, it'll go here. So 5x2 is a little bit too long. Let's just do some sort of standard, or like a 4x3. And then you can see here, as I adjust, say, the width, the height will automatically adjust to fit. So it turns out at 4x3, I can fit all six photos here on one page. Now, another variation on this is to go to Context Sheet. What Context Sheet is going to give you that the others aren't are captions and things underneath. So here you can adjust all sorts of different things, like the margins between the photos. And you can adjust how many columns are involved. And you get to have too many columns here, it will then go to another page. So you're not really worrying about the picture size per se, but how many you could fit on a page here. So we do it like that. And also you can go to captions, and there's a whole bunch of different styles for captions here that you can use. And you could add things like descriptions. This photo has a description on it. The camera that was used. You can include keywords, file name, all sorts of things that could come in handy. You could put there in the caption and print them out. So it's not so much printing to use for typical purposes, but maybe to print these out for somebody to be able to look at them and pick one out they like, or just for you to have a kind of a printed archive of your photos. And remember, with any of these, you can always print to PDF. So I can go to print, and then I can choose my printer and all the options that are specific to my printer. But I could also down here go to PDF and open it in preview, or save it directly to a PDF file. You also have the ability to do some interesting things, like adding the PDF to iBooks. So imagine, for instance, if I were to select all my photos, say several hundred from a set, and then print it like this, and it would be many pages, and then just add the PDF directly to iBooks. And then in iBooks on my iPad, I've got this book that I can page through showing all my photos. So there's a lot of cool little things you could do if you kind of think outside the box with the options in the PDF menu. Now, in any of these layouts where you can adjust the picture, so pretty much everything except for fit and context sheet, because context sheet is going to be driven by the number of columns, you can click on a photo and then zoom in on it and even adjust what part of the photo you want to print out. So you can do that without adjusting the photo itself. The original photo is untouched. It's just on this printout, it's going to zoom into this area of the photo. So you have the ability to do that. Now, of course, you can use other apps to print the photos from your iPhoto collection as well. For instance, let's go into Pages here and just create a blank document where I can view the layout, see the entire page here. I'm going to go to Setup and turn off the document body. So I basically have a page layout document here. I'm going to go to Media, and there's my photos from iPhoto, just the ones we were just looking at. So I can select one. It'll put it in here, and then I've got a ton of options how to size it to fit on this page. So for instance, I could go in and add a cool border to it, like a picture frame border. I can do some adjustments. I can go ahead and add some text and put the text underneath as a caption if I want. So there's a lot of different things I can do. I can either even put shapes like and arrows and such to point at things if I want to. So there's a lot you could do if you just you know, exit iPhoto but still use the photos there and use another app like Pages to create something really cool. And then I could just print this out onto a sheet and the photo will still be the same quality, but now I've got all this extra stuff that I've done and put on the page. You can also use Pages to do something that's not really possible to do in iPhoto in the current version. You can print multiple copies of the same photo. So I'm just going to take this photo back down to normal size here with normal options. Set it to be about 3 inches wide, and then I'm going to option drag to create duplicates of it. And I can take the time and line these up and then print this page out, and then I can have multiple copies of the same photo on one sheet of paper on my printer. And one last option you have I want to show you is to create a book. And you usually think of creating these as things you have Apple print for you, but you can create a book here and just you know, select any theme you want, create it, and you end up with pages in the book that you can print. You don't have to send it to Apple. So you can go here and say print, and you get the pages from the book here. So for instance, if I were to design just a page out of a book like this one right here, and I wanted to print, send that to my printer, I can select that. I can see that's page 4. So I could just send from 4 to 4 to the printer. And that's kind of handy to have, and you can do some nice design work in these books, ignoring the pages you're not going to actually print and just working on designing some cool pages that can be used to print at home. And then of course you can also save these out as PDFs. So it's also handy to create, say, a book that you never intend to print but intend to save as a PDF and view it that way.